Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus.
say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. So they shall impose my name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. The shepherds went in haste to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told them. When his days were completed for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
When 8 days were completed for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. 8 days. Today is the 8th day of Christmas, so hence the reading. 8 days after Jesus was born, he was given his name, and he was circumcised, which was a requirement of the Jewish law. Anytime in the Bible somebody is given a name or a name change, it means the person has special missions. In this case, Jesus, being a singular example of one whose mission was given directly by God. In fact, his birth itself was a miraculous one. It said that Mary treasured things in her heart. What she was doing was trying to answer the question, who is this child that was miraculously conceived in me? And over time, the answers would be given. Now, Jesus lived 30 years of a hidden life with his family. He was not very well known. In fact, even when he began his public ministry, then he started doing some things that really can't be explained merely humanly. He had power over nature. See him calming the storm, walking on the sea. In fact, he scared people, thought he was a ghost, but he wasn't a ghost. He exercised demons. And then, most strangely of all, he broke up funerals. Classic case with Lazarus, his friend who had been in the tomb for 4 days. He came out looking like a mummy, but he was alive again. Because Jesus said, Lazarus, come out. Now, Thomas Jefferson, who is one of our founding fathers, he's not the only one who did this, decided to excise all references to miracles in his Bible. He wanted to make Jesus into an ethical teacher, and that was it. Here's the reason. Because Jefferson and his cohorts didn't want to believe that God actually came into the world. They wanted to think that God was way, way out there somewhere and had no real interest in what goes on in the world. But in doing so, they basically denied the facts. Jesus was not just a teacher. He did things that we can't explain based on mere human power. So who is Jesus? Jesus is from God. Now, in order to preserve that, in 431, the bishops of the Catholic Church met in a special ecumenical council and gave the title Mother of God to the Blessed Virgin Mary. If you ever go down to Cincinnati, go across the river to Covington, Kentucky, and go to the cathedral there. It's called the Cathedral of the Assumption. The Cathedral of the Assumption is the largest stained glass window in the world. And the picture on the window depicts this council naming Mary as the Mother of God. Now, it doesn't mean that she's the Mother of the Trinity. It means that her Son, Jesus, is God with a human nature. So whenever we say things about the Blessed Mother, most of the time we're pointing to a Son. Only a human has a mother. And an angel doesn't have a mother, for example. And his divinity was something that pre-existed his conception. But he put on a human nature, so we point to Mary, Mother of God. Jesus is God. If Jesus is God, then we need to listen to him, follow him, never take him for granted. In fact, the name Jesus, according to Acts 4:12, is the only name given to men by which we are to be saved. When St. Joan of Arc was being burned to death, her enemies were watching her. The only thing she could say was Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. That name can supply for an act of contrition when someone's dying. He is the Savior. Now, I say this because we live in a society where many people have this idea that it really doesn't matter what we believe. It does matter. So what we need to do is live our faith. Many of us do. Praise God. I'm glad everybody's here. And don't ever come up with the idea that one never has to share his faith with anybody. Many people don't know who Jesus is. They think he's maybe just an interesting teacher. There's a fellow who used to come to Mass here, in fact, and he didn't go to confession, which was great. Stopped going. Why? Because he got caught up in the New Age movement. New Age says, Jesus was good for earlier ages. We don't need him today. We need him today. He's the one who will come again at the end of time to bring human history to its conclusion, judge the living and the dead. We need him. He's the only way to heaven. Thanks be to God that we have him. So live the faith, practice the faith, love the faith, spread the faith. Blessed Virgin Mary will help us in this regard. Now we're coming into a new year. Some people like to develop resolutions for the year. Sometimes they say, well, I need to lose weight or whatever. Well, that's fine. But I would ask people, put into the resolutions something about growth in the faith, growth in the prayer life, devotion to the Blessed Virgin Mary, maybe a daily rosary or something. And if that's the case, the year will see a spiritual improvement, a deepening of our faith, hope, charity. Jesus may become more and more what our life is about. We can be an image of Jesus, something like a little stained glass window through which the sun comes, brightens the world. Somebody once said that the only Bible that some people will read is what they see in us. Let's be true to that.
God almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that exists among us.
Beloved brothers and sisters, let us now turn to our Father who hears our prayers.
For the church, reflected in Mary, that we may faithfully bring forth Jesus Christ into our world. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all peoples under Mary's care, that in the coming year they may know peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, the poor, the persecuted, and abandoned, that they may be consoled by our mother's powerful protection. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families celebrating the New Year, that they may share the happiness of the family of Nazareth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sick, especially Stephanie Berman, Mia, and Paula Salini. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the departed, that God may grant them peace, especially Dorothy Kay, Larry Small, and Joseph Riley. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the deceased members of the Ferrante Mission, the areas of families, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we are grateful for all that you provide us materially and spiritually, and the hope that you give us in your Son. Please help us to be faithful to our calling, to live lives of holiness, truly reflect your Son, what we say and do. We pray these things through your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Thank you. to Christ, bless and glorify your name. Promise the solemnity of the motherhood of the blessed ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, he conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world eternal life, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, the minions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices be praised, joined with theirs in humble praise as we obey.
Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, his spouse, with your blessed apostles, and glorious martyrs,
with our baptismal and confirmation patrons and with all the saints, whose constant intercession in your presence be relied for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. We please to confirm the faith and charity, your pilgrim, your Connor, for your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayer for this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom we see so on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to be shed under your roof, but only say the word.
Jesus Christ is the same.
We have received this heavenly sacrament with joy, O Lord, and we pray that it may lead us to eternal life. For we rejoice to proclaim the blessed ever Virgin Mary, Mother of the Son and Mother of the Church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
To number 336, Hark the Herald Angels Sing. We'll be starting with the second verse.